From Mwangaza SDA Church. I didn't come alone, I came with my family. I'd like them to stand.
Happy Sabbath.
Happy day.
My name is Padmo Anyumba. I'm the father. It's my family.
Happy Sabbath. I'm Emily Muga, the mother.
It's good.
All the time.
And all the time.
The Lord is good.
My name is Andre Baraka, and I'm the last one. Yes, he's the last one. He talks about it every time. Okay. Today is commitment to God and service to man. Commitment to God and service to whom?
Man.
Our story comes from the book of Mark chapter 14, verse 32 to 42. Our key text comes from the book of John chapter 3, verse 16. And it says, "For God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." So, before we embark on our journey up with Jesus in a certain garden, let's pray. Almighty Father, thank you for giving us this day. Be with us and guide us. I'm just a vessel. Use me to speak to your children. Let your children understand. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Jesus went to a garden, children. What garden did he go to with his disciples? Which one? Garden of Gethsemane. Why did Jesus go to the Garden of Gethsemane? Jesus went to the Garden of Gethsemane to pray. Why did Jesus go to the Garden of Gethsemane to pray? Jesus went to the Garden of Gethsemane to pray because he was sorrowful in his heart. Why was Jesus sorrowful? Jesus was sorrowful because all his life, he just felt the love of God. But this time, he was going to face the wrath of God, not for the sins he did, but of the sins we did. Sometimes, badala wewe, uchapo mekula, for example, tiblingoko mekuja akakula sugar, sindio, sa wendo unachapwa. That was Jesus in that time. So, Jesus prayed. say this prayer. God, take this cup away from me. Nonetheless, not as I will, but as you will. Jesus was so stressed. He was sweaty. His sweat poured like droplets, great droplets of blood. But instead of Jesus staying and looking power, like asking, saying that I can put the power of myself, I can give myself the power, he went and asked God for strength to help him. Yes, God helped him, and he can help us too. He sent angels from heaven to come down and strengthen him. In this story, we see Jesus was following the path of God. What God wants is what he was doing. He said, even if it's very difficult for me to save mankind, I will still go. He asked for God's strength, but never he was never determined to his strength. We see anytime we're in difficulties, we need to go ask, not rely on our strength, but in God's strength.
Amen.
In this story, we see that Jesus saw there was no way man was going to be saved. The only punishment man had, they were going. Jesus did all this and all that payment and all that punishment happened at the cross. At the cross, at the cross, where God saw the love and the burden of my love rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Sometimes in life, things are very difficult to give out. You don't have the strength, you don't have the item, but all that we should do is ask for God's strength. We are just a prayer away from God. Like for example, in school, you have two pens. All of that is pens that you cherish, your grandma gave you and maybe she died. But it is very difficult for you to give your friend because this is the only thing I have to remember my grandma. It was very difficult for Jesus to die because he was going to be separated with the only person who taught him love, God. But because he loved us, he decided, I'm not gonna let my brethren die. I'm going to die for them instead. So children, let's all have love in our hearts. If Jesus never had love and saw himself, me, the Son of God, come die for these sinners, will we be saved? Instead of being saved, we could be dead. We could have carried that cross. We could be flogged those stocks that Jesus was given. But because of the love of God and the way he was committed to God's plan and had service to man, we are all saved.
Amen.
How many of us want to be like Jesus? Very hard to go follow the path because it's very hard not having the power. But if you want to have the power of Christ in you, raise up your hands. Let's pray. Almighty Father, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, your children have come before you. They have risen up your hand. God, send your spirit upon us. Let us be committed to your plans every day, and let us serve other people, even if it is difficult. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Above all,